Hello friends, this is Durga from IT University. Sometime back we have published a course called as CCA 131 Cloud Certified Hadoop and Spark Administrator in Udemy. You can actually purchase this course for $10 by going to the description and clicking on the link. When it comes to the course, it will actually walk you through step by step to provision the servers from GCP leveraging the $300 credits which are provided by Google for anyone. And then automate the mundane tasks or tedious tasks by using Ansible. Then we will actually walk you through about setting up all the components with respect to big data cluster using Cloudera distribution. You will not only learn Cloudera administration as part of this course, you will also be prepared for giving the certification with confidence. So in case if you are interested, look out in the description and you should be able to get the link for $10 and you can purchase the course. When we actually set up some components such as load balancers in Hue, it actually fails with respect to permission denied issue. So if you look at this, at this time the Hue is configured on the cluster. The Hue server is started without any issues, but when it comes to load balancer, it is failing. You can see the status, it is down. So if you try to restart, it will again fail, and you can actually look at the logs to understand why it is failing. So as of now, it is trying to stop. It has stopped and then it is trying to start. It is trying to start both load balancer as well as Hue server. If you expand the load balancer and if you go to standard error, it says permission denied. You can actually search for it. It is trying to open this file under var run Cloudera SCM agent process etc. And it is failing with permission denied exception or error. So we will not be able to start until this issue is resolved. It is not a good practice to go and change the permissions to whatever user which is being used here. Rather than doing that, we have to add the SELinux rules. So dealing with SELinux is a bit complicated and it is a bit advanced stuff. I am not going to deal with SELinux to address this issue. For now, what I will be doing is, I will just disable SELinux on the server where the Hue is configured. But as per your corporate policy, if SELinux has to be used, then you have to probably define the rules as part of SELinux. SELinux stands for Security Enforcing Linux, and it is part of the Red Hat or Red Hat flavor distribution such as CentOS, Fedora, etc. That being said, the way you can disable swappiness is, in this case, you can actually connect to the Big Data Server 1 and then you can actually go to this location called as, but for going to that location, you have to first sudo as root and then you can actually go to etc SELinux. Okay, it is a file, I think, that's why I can say etc. Yeah, it's a directory only. So you can either say cd etc SELinux and then once you are in the SELinux folder, you can open this config file. As part of the config file, you have to change this enforcing to disabled. However, this is not good enough. You cannot just disable by updating this file. It will take care whenever you reboot the machine, it will ensure that SELinux is disabled. But for the active sessions in the server, we have to disable. Further, there is a command. Let us explore what that command is. You can actually go to the official documentation of Cloudera itself. The command is nothing but set enforce 0. If you want to first get the current value, you can say get enforce and hit enter. It is saying enforcing, which means you have to define rules to ensure that only authorized tasks are happening for authenticated users or authorized users. Now we can actually say set enforce 0 and now if we say get enforce, it will get permissive. Okay, and then we have disabled on reboots by updating the config file. Now what we can do is, we can go back and we should be able to restart this and it will restart without any issues. So keep it in mind that if your organization is compliant with respect to SELinux, you should not go ahead and change the configuration file or set enforce to zero. Rather, you have to define the rules following the CloudEra documentation. Okay, so let's wait until this is done and then we'll see. So for the currently running commands, you can always click on this. Okay, as of now, there are no current running commands. You can actually say all recent commands and you can actually see whether the last command is successful or not. You can also click on this and ensure that everything is started. So in this case, I'm expanding all the two roles, or all the roles which are nothing but two are started without any issues, and those roles are nothing but Hue server and load balancer. Now we should go to the CloudEra manager and we can click on Hue and we can ensure that everything looks good. You should see the status summary. If there are any errors, you have to troubleshoot and fix those errors. That being said, at ITVarsity, we actually provide training on CloudEra administration, especially from CCI 131 perspective. If you are interested in learning the CloudEra administration, or if you want to prepare for CCI 131, watch out in the description link. As part of the description link, we have a $10 coupon. Using that $10 coupon, you should be able to sign up for the course.